then we'll come back with proper.
Man, it's about time she gave us a break. I can't stand that song.
Man, all you do is complain and complain. For as long as I've known you, all you do is complain.
Yeah, right, Silla. Look who's talking. The one who said she was going to be a preacher or singer.
Can I record this
one? Well, good, man. Don't be caught on her. Hey, God still loves you. Just rededicate your life to him and ask for forgiveness. For the Bible says in Romans 10:9, if you confess with thy mouth that the Lord Jesus and shall believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, then thou shalt be saved.
Here we go again. Why don't you just stay up? All you have to do is go to church, sing in the choir, stay away from drugs and all that stuff. You'll go to heaven.
Girl, it's the biggest lie the devil's introduced in the church. Because Jesus says, except a man be born again, you cannot see the kingdom of heaven.
Man, I tried that. I didn't feel a thing. I didn't feel no change. Besides, if there was a God, why is there so much street violence and kids dying these days?
Because in Romans 2:8-9 it says, unto them that are conscience and do not obey the truth, but obey unrighteousness, indignation and wrath, tribulation and anguish, and upon every soul of man that doeth evil. And that's why the whole world has chosen to reject God. And in Joshua 3:24-15 it says, choose you this day who ye will serve. The choice you make now determines the state of your life from here to eternity.
I don't think God will give me a second chance. I already blew with him once. Why should he give me a second chance? You are what you are because you decided you want to be that way. If you really want to change, you can do anything. You can just put your mind to it.
Why don't you just chill on that? Take it as it comes. Lead a good, clean life. You'll go to heaven.
I hope I don't end up in the wrong game.
Wiki, why is it quiet? Why haven't you said anything?
Look, I know Jesus is coming soon, but it's hard for me to give up my friends and my music. But then again, I agree with Gene. Doesn't the Bible say something about God is God of love?
Yes, he does love us. In fact, the Bible says in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Whatsoever shall believe in him should not perish, but shall ever have everlasting life.
Man, why don't you just say it on your religious talk? I'm only here because my parents made me come. Why don't you just change the subject?
You've seen the back.
You know who I haven't seen in a while? It was Lonnie. Have any of you guys seen him?
Man, that boy's in and out of juvie. He's either going to end up on the streets or locked up in prison. Yeah, I don't think blood's ever going to change.
Nothing's impossible with God. I always pray for Lonnie, just like I pray for you guys.
No.
Come on, you guys. Let's just practice again and then we can go home. Guys, we do this. The intro to this is the whole chorus. Then you guys do it, okay? No, it isn't. But then you got to right.
Life.
Richard wants you to special. You guys are in the back against the wall again. Come up.
Hey, get in the back.
Yeah, you should stay there during the play.
Yeah, you should do all that. You see all the
trees. You guys are here, right?
So the back, see, put the thing where you said it.
I do it.
REC, you got to get it first. Okay.
We can go through this life, living as we do, making changes here and there to either improve our life or we can leave it as it is. Yet there are two things that the Bible says we must do. And in Hebrews 9, verse 27, it is written, and it is appointed unto man, you can think that for yourself, once to die, but after this, the judgment. No matter how we live, no matter what we do, no matter what we believe, we are appointed to die, and we have an appointment to stand before the throne of God in judgment. It cannot be broken, it cannot be canceled, and it cannot be avoided.
I miss some of the preaching. I knew the lady who picked up your guys. Oh well, as long as you guys still come to church.
Hey, you guys, check it out. It's Lonnie. He's sitting right there. If there's anybody who needs to hear this preaching, it's him.
Mm-hmm. Well, if it's here, there's still hope that someday you'll all get saved.
Well, I don't think your hopes are too high.
Yeah, we want you to say it's the same old thing.
Well, Jesus is the same today and forever. Don't you realize not only the thought of the sinners then, but the sinners now and the sinners tomorrow? His blood still cleanses today and forever. When he was on the cross, you and I were on his mind.
Oh, no, you ain't gonna start witnessing to this again, are you?
Until the day I die.
I hope that day's good.
Standing before God in judgment for your sins, for my sins. Because in Romans 6:23 it says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. It's going to be a time of standing before God in open rebellion to God. Some of us say, I've never rebelled against God. But yet God says, because you did not accept him, you are in open rebellion to God. For some, it'll be a time when we stand before judgment because we at one time accepted Christ and we turned away. But you know, irregardless of our pride, irregardless of our open rebellion to God, irregardless of what we think or say or do. In Philippians chapter 2, verse 10 and 11, it says that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of the Father. You know, some say we won't be judged. Some religions say we don't have to be judged. But my friend, God's word tonight says we must go before God in judgment. And when God says we must stand before him in judgment, then church tonight, we must stand before God in judgment. And one day, irregardless of what we think, irregardless of what we say, irregardless of what we do, one day we're going to stand before God in judgment. To know that we're going to stand before God in judgment is for sure. Because his word says we must stand before him in judgment. To know that we're going to die is for sure. Because his word says we must die. We have no choice in these two matters. The only thing we do have a choice in is where we will spend eternity. Whether we'll spend it in heaven or whether we'll spend it in hell. To go to hell, you don't have to do anything in your life. Just keep living the life you're living. Just keep doing what you're doing. And hell will be guaranteed. To go to heaven, there's one more thing we must do. And Jesus said we must be born again. And to be born again, he said we must confess with our mouths Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior and accept him in our heart. Before I close tonight, I just want to bring one more passage of scripture. And it's found in Matthew 7, verse 24. And it's a parable of the two builders. It's a parable that we all know. Do you realize that both builders were given the same material to build their house? They were hit with the same wind. They were hit with the same flood. They were hit with the same rain. But the Bible says only one stood, while the other was destroyed. Only the house that was built upon the rock was the house that stood. You know what Jesus is saying in this parable is? For you to build your life without Jesus Christ as your foundation is to have your life destroyed. For you to keep doing what you're doing and not include God is like this man who built his house upon the sand. And it's going to be destroyed. But you see, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever believeth in him should not die, should not perish, but have everlasting life. Jesus died for our sins. And in Revelation 3, verse 20, he says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man open the door, I will come in and sup with him and he with me. Jesus is here tonight knocking on your heart. Shall we all stand? If you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, then my friend, you are on your way to an eternal hell. Jesus is here tonight knocking on your heart. And he's asking you to let him in. If you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, the altars are open for you tonight. Thank you.
died for you. Because you came forward tonight, I want you to know that the rest of your life is going to be different. I'm going to lead you tonight in the sinner's prayer. And then one of the counselors are going to take you into the back and give you some counseling and pray with you. Our Father in heaven, Lord, I come before you a sinner. And I know I need Jesus in my life. And Father, I accept your son Jesus and what he did on Calvary for my sins. And I thank you, Father, for Jesus not only died, but he rose again for me. And Jesus, I accept you in my heart tonight. Thank each and every one of you for being here. And it's my hope and prayer that if you didn't accept Jesus Christ tonight, that you will be given another opportunity to accept him. And it's my hope and prayer that God go with each and every one of us as we go our separate ways. We're going to dismiss tonight in prayer. Don't forget our service on Sunday, 11 o'clock. Our gracious and heavenly Father, as we just come once more before your throne tonight, Father God. Father, we just thank you and we just praise you for your word which was spoken tonight, Father God. And we thank you and praise you for the unction of your Holy Spirit which moved and convicted this brother tonight, Father. We just ask and pray that you strengthen and bless this brother Lonnie, Father God, and that you just use him in a mighty way for your kingdom, Father God. We ask and pray that you be with each and every one of us as we go our separate ways tonight, Father God. And Lord, we just ask and pray that you just lead and guide us through the remainder of this weekend until we gather together on Sunday. In Jesus' name, let God's people say,
amen.
Shake hands.
I'm going to check out how Lonnie's doing.
Okay.
Did you see Lonnie?
I can't believe Lonnie went up to the altar. Him of all people, you think he'd be the last one to go up?
No. Well, I can't believe he really did. All things he's done. But then again, after the guilt trip passed through at us, I almost went up too, and I don't even believe in God.
Well, at least he went up. I know the feeling he's feeling. I used to know what it was like knowing that I was going to make it to heaven. And then again, maybe if I didn't let my friends get in the way, I'd still have that feeling.
Man, I almost went up again when the pastor said that we would have to be judged for everything we ever done. But then, since I seen you guys didn't go up, I didn't go up either.
Well, I didn't like it when he said, there's none righteous, no, not one. I live a good, clean life. I think I'm going to make it.
Remember to read your Bible and pray. And if you need someone to talk to, give me a call. In fact, you'll drive it home. But how does he feel to be saved?
I feel brand new.
Oh.
So fresh.
So what?
Oh, no. Now there's two of them. Just what we need it.
Hey, look, you guys. If God could clean his life from alcohol and drugs, don't you think he could change us too?
No. You mean you guys are not saved?
You got what?
Man, I'm happy for you, but don't push your gospel off on us. I'm saved for you.
I know I'm going to make it, but I'm not too sure you're going to make it on one night of repentance.
I know Jesus is coming, and I want to get saved, but I'm just not ready.
I know I need help, but I think I blew my chance with God the first time.
Look, it says in 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, he's just and... And in Hebrews 3:15, it says, if you hear his voice, harden not your heart.
Man, I'm not ready yet. Maybe next time.
Man, let's get out of here.
I'll be right out. I'm going to say goodbye to Pastor. Don't forget your Bibles now.
Jesus said, here I stand. Won't you please let me in? I will tomorrow. Jesus said, I am he who supplies all your needs. And you said, I know. Tomorrow.
I'll be right out.
Got into a very, very
extra thing.
Driver of the other car was charged with drunk driving. He was the only survivor of the accident.